What's up, YouTube? We're back with another awesome moto vlog. So the main purpose of this video is actually to continue the upgrading of the interior of the GX470. And for me, the biggest thing was, and I'll show some clips here, this shift boot being this really just gross. It's like a lighter or medium tone gray, and it's just stained from all the years and the previous owner. I cleaned it quite a bit when I got the vehicle, and it looks a little bit better, but it just looks a little raggedy. And this shift knob for the high and low select is kind of gross as well. Let me just turn this down and get some shots of it here. Hopefully you can see this well. This was just stained. The quality of the material has deteriorated. It's just not in as good a condition as I would like it to be. More importantly, this gear select for the high and low gear on the four-wheel drive, this boot is also as bad, if not worse, and this top selector knob is just kind of tattered and worn. So I've got a couple of options here to help us upgrade the interior look here. So what I've got to fix the boots and also the knob, I got some shift knobs off of Amazon, and I also got some shift boots. So this is a shift boot that I had found on Amazon, and the dimensions of it looked about right to this. I think we're gonna have some extra material, so it'll be good. Gives us some flexibility with setting this up and making everything fit nice, so we have some extra material there. But if you can see, hopefully this focuses, you can see it is a nice black leather shift boot, and we have the red stitching in there as well. So I think this is gonna give a nice look to the interior here, and I've been kind of going with this red and black theme on everything in the car, so I think this will look really good. And then I got two of them, one for the four-wheel drive control gear select, and then also one for just the regular drive select knob. And then here I've got two different knobs that I had found. So I'll link all of the stuff in the description below, so if anybody's interested in getting this exact setup, you can see exactly what I bought if you want to go this route. There are other color options for the shift boots, so there's some different stitching and different colors as well, so that's really nice. The main thing you want to go for if you are selecting a different knob from the ones I'm going with is you want to go for an M8, 8mm, and a 1.25 thread pitch. So that's the main thing. If you stick with that, you can get any gear selector knob that you like. There's some cool ones that look like samurai swords. Almost went that path, but I decided to go with something a little bit more straightforward. For the four-wheel drive select, I went with this red carbon fiber finished knob. I think this will look really cool. Give a touch of red to go with the black. And also everything in here slowly getting kind of some black brought in to try to make, to tone out some of all this cream, because I'm not a real big fan of the cream interior. So this is gonna go for the four-wheel drive control, give a little bit of red into the interior, which I like. And for the regular gear selector, I went with a black shift knob. And the cool thing about these is they're somewhat universal. They've got a couple of different sizes here for threading, but like I said, the main thing you want to be focused on when you're, if you're going to order something different than the ones I did, is the M8 and the 1.25 on the thread pitch. So this is the gear select knob I went with for the main gear selector. It is just a machined black aluminum, kind of a simple, I didn't want to go too wild with these. I just want something clean, something that looks good. So I think this will look good, and it'll fit that gear selector threading with these adapters. So should be a very easy install, something that everybody can do at home, something that you can all add and upgrade the interior of your vehicle, if you just want to add some cool gear selectors and just have a little bit more personalized interior. So as I did in an earlier vlog, I had wrapped some of the wood trim with vinyl wrap, and that has worked out well. Actually need to talk about that real quick, so something I want to change during this video, and I'll just document it along the way. The vinyl wrap here around the vents, it's a little bit worse up top here, you can see. Yeah, here it's peeling, and this just doesn't work well around this curved surface, just because of the fact that it's getting heat all the time from the sun and just being in the car in general. I do use a sun visor, so the sun visor should be reducing some of the heat, but still it's peeling up and I just don't like the way it looks. So we're gonna address that too. So we're gonna address that with doing a semi-gloss paint. This is a Rust-Oleum semi-gloss paint. It's a paint and primer. While I'm taking this apart to do the mod that this video is about, I'm gonna paint those with a semi-gloss paint. It'll match it up with the Phoenix Automotive head unit. I think it'll look good. And I also think I'm gonna tape off and paint this upper control screen as well, so that matches in the satin black as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, just update you on the vinyl wrap. Everything else held up great to the heat and everything. It's just this curvature, and there's always cold air blowing out from the AC, and it's getting heat from the sun, so it's kind of like just drastically changing temperature all the time, and it just doesn't hold up well around those areas. So gotta fix that, and I think it'll make everything look a lot cleaner here. This should be a very easy process. I'm excited to just kind of go ahead and do this, and we'll see where it goes. I've documented how to take this interior apart before, so I'm probably not going to emphasize all of that, but I am going to start disassembling everything so that I can get this out and change out these boots, because the main thing we got to do here is just get in and pull the boots out and unthread these knobs. We should be able to get into adapting the leather boots to where the stock boots were fit up to. So let's just start taking things apart and we'll see how it goes. So I've got this center console piece just kind of sitting in here, and I've got the paint drying outside on the main part of the center console up near the head unit. I pulled this piece, it just kind of, you can just push the sides, this plastic in here, just kind of pulls apart real easily, and there's some staples around here. Basically there's just a little plastic ring in here that's rectangular shaped to fit inside of this hole, and then I'm just gonna go through and I guess just remove these staples holding it together. Looks like there is maybe some dabs of glue on here as well to kind of hold everything together, but here's the old shift boot. We want to go ahead and kind of fix that up to this boot here, and I'm just gonna kind of pick an area that I think will be the front. I had some Loctite 5-minute epoxy. I'm gonna mix up a little bit of this 5-minute epoxy and at least tack in these pieces around the sides here. And then once it's tacked in, it should be able to just pop back into this fixture here. Really the goal here is just to get a little bit of attack to this, and once it's in there, it kind of presses and holds itself into place. All right, so now that's mixed up, I have these handy little chip bag springs. So these will actually probably hold this fabric down on this edge and keep it held in place pretty nice. So I'll try that out. And so for this selector boot for the four-wheel drive, this is a very similar situation. It has kind of a plastic ring that's stapled to the fabric, and this just kind of flexes, and you just pull it, and it comes right out like that. Super easy to get to, and same type of thing here. We're going to have to take, as you can see, there's staples holding it together, and it's holding it on this little plastic ring. It's like a rectangular plastic ridge that holds it all on. We'll just take the staples out. All right, that came off real easily, and set that off to the side. So now we still have this. This is the rectangular kind of ring that holds the form of the shift boot. And this one is a little bit bigger than the other one, so we'll have to kind of size this up. Still probably need to cut quite a bit, looks like, from here. I'd say, having excess on there is not a bad thing either. I'm being a little bit conservative. I'm going to cut this. I'm going to cut what looks to me like about an inch to an inch and a half off the bottom here. It probably feels weird cutting something that you just bought brand new, but this is kind of the stuff you have to do when you're making a custom piece like this. You're going to have to cut some stuff and make it work for you. So that's what we're gonna do. So I'm just kind of stretching this around before tacking it in to see if, first off, see how it fits, and also maybe get away without tacking it. It'd be nice if I could stretch this material around this rectangular piece and save myself some trouble with glue. And there we go. So we got that boot fit in there pretty well. And it fits in nice and snug, as you can see. And the red stitching looks pretty darn cool.
So overall, this turned out really good. It looks good with the black, I think. So that's one down. All right, so starting to take the clips off of this other piece that we had the 5-minute epoxy on. And that epoxy's holding up well there on that side. Since that kind of holds it in place, the rest of this can kind of just tuck in just like the other piece. And so I'm going to slide this up through the bottom here. There we go. Got some extra material there, as you can see. But that can just fold under. If you really want to, you could maybe glue that up under from the other side and make it look better. But as you can see, now this fits in there all nice. Looks good. This should just click back inside of there. And there we have it. Those are the two new boots mounted in. It looks pretty cool in my opinion. So I'm going to go back out to the car and start putting this all back together, and we'll screw in the new shift knobs on here so we get that newer look. I almost kind of want to, now that we're upgrading things, I almost kind of want to go look around on Amazon and see if I can find a shift boot or a e-brake boot cover to match these, because I really like the way this looks. It looks way cleaner, makes things look new. So yeah, I'm going to go install these in the vehicle and we'll start putting the gear selector knobs on there and see how it looks. Alright, so overall, the difficulty of this install was pretty low. You can trim the four-wheel drive selector boot that you order if you're going this route. You can trim that up a little bit, make it match the length of the original one that was in there. That's really the key to all of this, is just making sure the lengths match up. But I would say this was a very easy install to do once that was figured out. I'm really digging the way this looks. I like the red shift knob look on the four-wheel drive control. I think what I might do is I might try to get some sort of sticker pack that's like an alphabet that has a nice font. I really don't want to put a font on there that looks tacky, or like a label maker sticker, because I think that'll just make it look cheap. But if I can find some like cool, like rugged looking font sticker pack on Amazon, I will order that and add the high, low, and neutral position indicators on that so that I can remember. I took a picture of the shift knob so I remember myself, but it's very straightforward in your head. You can think pulling all the way back is high, so you're pulling high up, you're pulling up, that's the high. Middle's neutral, and pushing it all the way forward is low, so you're pushing it down, low. Intuitively, I think it kind of makes sense in general what position it is, but I think it would be kind of cool to have a nice label on there just to complete the look and make it look a little bit more professional. But I must say overall, I really like the look of this. It looks cleaner. I would really like to replace the e-brake boot now, because as you can see, it's kind of sticks out a little bit like a sore thumb now. It's not so bad. I mean, I'm not a fan of this gray leather. It's yellowed and stained, and I've taken leather cleaner to it, and it's cleaned it up some, but just generally it needs replaced. I think it'd be nice to have a black handle here, and then the same matching black and red boot. I think what it does is it really cleans up this interior look here, and And in general, it just kind of makes the feel of the inside here a little bit more modern. Really now, so now it's been a total of about a week with the other shift boot and also the dash upgrade that I did at the beginning of the video. And I'm loving the fact that I have an all black center console here. I'll kind of turn the camera again just to show it. This overall just looks so much more clean with all black paint. So the paint's holding up very well. It looks clean and the coating applied very well. I just took some light, like 600 grit sandpaper to everything to help get it to stick. So that was also a nice improvement. This entire video documented, and I know, two different things, just the painting of that, but also the shift boots. But I thought it kind of belonged together as a upgrading of the interior, and I wanted to give an update because I know a lot of you have probably seen my video where I've wrapped a lot of these trim pieces here, and I wanted to just update everybody and let you know that it's gonna cause issues with the vinyl trim if you have it wrapped around those vents, because those vents are gonna generate heat and blow cold air, and it's gonna slowly just degrade the vinyl quality. The adhesive is gonna get hot and cold, and those temperature changes are really just gonna make it not form well around those vents. So I wanted to update you so you know that if you're gonna go wrap these, you may run into that issue, but I think there's many solutions for this and many different colors of paints you could go with. I think it looks great in the all black look. It cleans up all the area. It makes everything match really well. But if you're interested in doing different colors, you can always go with that. If you're going with specific, you know, you could color match to the outside of your vehicle if you want, or go with a different color. So I'm going to end things here. I really think that this was a nice, easy, do-it-yourself kind of a mod for the GX470. If any of you end up going down this route and you have questions, feel free to reach out. I went through a little bit of trouble myself learning, you know, how to take things apart and how to get the boots on. Hopefully you can understand from the video enough to do it yourself if you want to. Let me know in the comments down below if you actually like this upgrade, if you think it looks better, or if you think I should have just went with an OEM shift boot and knob and just upgraded that. I really like the way this looks. I think it's different than other vehicles out there that you see. So, you know, there's not a lot of GXs out there using this kind of shift boot and knob setup. I think it's cool for that reason, because it's a little bit different and it makes the car feel a little bit more custom to me. But let me know what everybody thinks down in the comments. If you liked this mod, give the video a thumbs up. I really appreciate that. It helps me understand if everybody's liking the videos and the content of the videos. So hitting the like button really helps me indicate which videos people like more, and then I can start to tailor the content to you, what you want as viewers. If you're not already a subscriber and you like GX470 content, I make GX470 videos, and I've been kind of increasing the output of the videos lately. So if you're interested in GX470 content and you want to get notified whenever I upload new videos, hit that subscribe button down below. It'll let you know when I upload a new video. And also, I've been doing some reaching out into the live stream types of content lately, so it'll also let you know if I do any live stream events. Just as a heads up, if you really want to get engaged, hitting the subscribe button helps me out a lot. Helps me understand whether or not the videos I'm making are helpful to people. And I really like this community that we're building of GX470 owners. We're all kind of engaging really well in the comments, and I'm really enjoying the feedback from everybody. And so I'm going to continue to make these videos because they're fun for me. And if you're interested in those and you want to join our community of GX owners, subscribe. You're going to enjoy it. Everybody's really nice. And I really plan to start increasing the content on the Facebook page as well, because I think the Facebook page might be another format for people to talk together about some of the mods. You can see the videos on there, what I'm working with. And everyone can kind of engage a little bit more as a community on Facebook as well. So if you're interested in that, go follow me on Facebook, and that will be a lot nicer of a community for everyone to engage and talk more. The comment section is great for that as well. The comment section in these videos is very active, and I love that everybody chimes in and helps each other out with questions that they have. It's really cool to see. It almost turns itself into a little blog itself in the comments. So I really appreciate everyone's engagement, and I'm going to end things here. So thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.